Hello everyone, Alzeon the Great here. Welcome back to League of Legends Manager on Moba GM. We left off, SI Gaming was not doing great after their first win. Five straight losses after their win to the Aether Wolves in the third game of the season. Here's where the standings currently sit. Your defending champions, Paladin, are only 5-3 as of right now. Even though they did not change the starting roster, your number one team currently is Crystal. With their top side of Datafuse and Leofrost. But right now, I have one change that we are making to the roster. Basically, I looked it over, and we've lost five games in a row, okay? After, you know, winning that game. Over the course of the season, Sours has the worst KDA at 0.9. When we lose, it's bad. I mean, like, it's worse for him. Like, it's bad, but it's worse for Sours. But at the same time, sometimes it's like sometimes when we lose, it's not terrible. Like we get kills or something. He's mainly the guy who's getting the kills, and it's either really good or really bad. And then occasionally when we lose, you know, sometimes in the middle from South. But usually, it's, you know. Well, obviously, with this season, we've only won a single game, so it's, you know, either everyone's doing terrible, including Sours, or Sours is the best player. And I don't really have a reason to start Bixie here. I want to see what he can do. I mean, keep in mind, Bixie, who will now be our starting top laner, he didn't play on Paladin, but he does have a championship, because, you know, he was on Paladin's roster. But yeah, he doesn't have a... he was on that team. Maybe we can, you know, get some of that Paladin magic onto our roster. By no means do I have a whole bunch of plans to, you know, make this permanent. But I want to get through, you know, a significant chunk of the season. Especially if we just keep losing. If we're not winning, then I don't want to be in here much longer. So, if we're not going to win any more games, then we're probably just going to go ahead and sim to the end. So, right now, the plan is we're going to sim a couple games and see where we go from there. Our next two games are against Primal. Yeah, against Primal Gaming. Back-to-back games against Primal. And we'll face the 207 Shock Crystal and however far we go. I might draft against Paladin. Probably draft against these three. So like sim these first four games, then draft against these three. And then we'll see if we sim anything after. So let's sim four games right now. Let's see if we can win with four games with Bixie on. First game is a loss, of course. To Primal Gaming. Bixie in his debut, 1-2-0 on Sion. And Jirian and Kirchhoff also got killed, but Tornado and Pumper did not. Yep, just bad. Another game. You lose back-to-back games against Primal. And Bixie got a kill. He went 1-6-3 though, so not the best. Definitely not the best. One more. They lost to the 207 Shock. Now in this game, we actually had two members with not terrible KDAs. Bixie went 3-1-3 on Kale. And Tornado on Ashe went 3-2-2. So you know what? Bixie's already had the best performance since, you know, the win. I mean, Like, Sours in that game was 3-2 and 10. Yeah, no, pretty much nothing's gonna beat Angerian and Kirchhoff for Tornado's record in that game. But, I mean, hey, Bixie got, you know, we were competitive against 207 Shock. That is not bad at all. We got one more game to sim before we get into drafting. One more week. That was a bye week. One more week so we can get a game in. And we lose to Crystal. Well, Bixie killed Data Fuse. And Tornado killed an eye. But yeah, wasn't expecting to win against Crystal anyway. Hey, I mean, we got, you know, 3 towers. Not like the start of the season game. I mean, we've been consistently getting some towers, you know, for most of the year. So, let's take a look at the league leaders real quick. Rusty and Data Fuse are tied for the league leader in kills. However, Rusty takes the edge as he has a higher KDA. Milikos still leads the league in assists, and Amanatsu leads the league in CS. So through those four games, Bixie has a 0.9 KDA, and he's averaging 0.1 gold more than Sounds. That's hilarious. But before we start drafting, take a look at the standings. Actually, before I start drafting, I have to do something else. Because yeah, SI Gaming, once again, 12th place in the league. Paladin has reclaimed first place. It's Crystal and Quantum. They'll sit in second and third.
Yod!
Excuse me. There's a Primal and 207 Shock at 10-5. Excalibur would round out the playoffs if it started today. But before we draft, there's actually something I do want to look at, and that is the prospects for this next year. I actually have saved now. I don't remember the prospects from the first season. I know they're rookies. But, you know, I've actually saved and recorded every single prospect, their name, and their position overall potential already. And I'm going to share with you my top five prospects, plus a guy I want to just point out. So obviously the number one prospect, Elijah Sabins, Duke. 56 overall, 100 potential. Best mental trait is his leadership. Best tactical trait is his team fighting. And best game trait is his summoner spells. Duke is the next generation of mid, say the least. Yeah. I didn't see nothing a whole bunch to say about these prospects. Besides, you know their name, who they are. Dennis Shaba Brown is, however, higher rated, although he's second. 58 overall, 100 potential. Highest mental is his team player at 77. Best tactical is his awareness at 80, and best game is his summoner spells at 78. Get out lane, team fight, or last hit. He is a split pushing jungler, to say the least. Although I think team fighting is not, I guess it's kind of geared towards other players. The third best prospect and third guy on the list with an asterisk to his name is Tom Oli, Jester. In the top lane. 56 overall, 100 potential. His best mental ability is his consistency, which is rare. His best tactical trait is his awareness, which is, once again, rare. And his best game sense would be skill shots. So, maybe he plays ranged top laners a lot. We'll see. Now, my personal favorite name and prospect in this class is Marcus Mays, Moonlepa. 57 overall, 100 potential, he is a top laner. He's not really good on the mental side, it's a tie between adaptability, fortitude, and team player for that, but he's a very good tactical player. He's a great laner with great awareness and in team fight. He's also really good at farming and, you know, pretty decent at positioning and hitting skill shots. Moonleffa, if I could sign one player, it would be him. I would love to sign Moonleffa. Obviously, nothing on the watch list, because, you know, watch list is kind of broken. But yeah, and there are two other guys. Favorite 80 carry prospect is the cool named Steve Winter White at 55 overall, 100 potential. He's a team player with his best mental ability. He's very aware, and this guy can team fight. He's not the best in the lane, but once you get him out of the lane, oh man, can this guy team fight. As far as his game stats, he can hit skill shots. So yeah, Winter is probably the best team fighting 80 carry prospect this game has seen so far. And the last guy I want to show before we get into drafting would be Kevin Kronos May Thompson at support. His best mental stat is team player. Tactical stats would be risk taking and game stats. Weird enough, on a support, he can hit skill shots. Don't give him brush. Do not give him brush. He will make you pay. But yeah, those are the top prospects that I have mentioned. Everyone, so obviously Duke, Shaba, and Jester are the top three in theirs, mid jungle top. My favorite prospect is Moonleffa. Winter is the best AD carry, and Kronos is the best support. But yeah, haven't done any of these yet. I don't know what hitting customize means. I'll find that out after this episode. Yeah, let's get into drafting. So, where is schedulers? Since we're not winning, I will draft these next three games. And then we'll probably sim the next three as well and get down to the last four games of the week. We are up against Paladin Esports with Rusty, Dark, Flanker, Sander, and Willikas. They're the defending champs. Rusty obviously has the most or the highest KDA in the league right now. So I'm gonna roll with Vixie for just this game, because it's a revenge game. Vixie, you remember, he was the backup on Paladin. So I want Vixie to play at least against Paladin, and then I'll sub back inside. Yeah, let's do a draft. We are on blue side. I will see you afterwards. Well, the first draft usually never is or isn't good whenever I come back into recording these series, but I actually think I did pretty good in this one. They banned Renekton, Lucian, Nidalee. We banned Draven, Anivia, Qiyana. And basically coming out, I was like, well, I'm not gonna first pick Gnar with every single counter imaginable available. So I went ahead and said, hey, we have to pull out some special stuff. Especially if we're against the best team and we only really have one win. So I decided to select Brand. They picked Karma Kennen, and Kennen does not counter Gnar, so I was like, okay, I'll just pick Gnar. And then I also remembered Tornado, and I wanted to keep the Brand flex alive, so I also remembered Tornado's best play today so far was on Ashe. So I locked in Ashe for Tornado. They picked Echo, banned Lipstick and Jinx, we banned Kai'Sa and Xayah. Then this is the first oof I made in the draft. They picked Graves. I thought they, for some reason I was like, maybe they banned Graves. And I picked Nunu. Not that, you know, Nunu is bad in Graves or Graves is good in Nunu, it's just I could have counterpicked the Graves. But yeah, they picked Graves, they picked Nunu and Leona, and they picked Callisto, which is the only remaining counter to Ashe. Even though it was a good draft, I doubt we're gonna win. It is Paladin. Although the last time we lost, it was the closest loss, like, yeah, the last time we lost, it was really close. Kirchhoff was playing Sylas, and he got 6 kills in that game. Hopefully we can, you know, change, hopefully we can get a similar outcome, but a win. Stop. Yeah. 3-10. Vixie did good on Gnar, and Tornado did good on Ashe. Alright. It's okay. Vixie's kinda earned it now. Like, he's actually been performing pretty consistently good. As far as, like, you know, he's actually been doing good. So I think I'm actually gonna start Vixie for the rest of the episode. Right, so yeah, Vixie will stay in for the rest of the episode. And we will play our next game against Rival Draft, our next game against Jade Crown Gaming. So, it was an okay draft. Draven, Anivia, Renekton, Rillaboom this time, because Jade Crown banned out Gnar, Illusion, and Jin Zhao. I went with the brand again. I felt like it was a good point for us. They picked Sona Zillion, and then I had a little debate if I wanted to, just instantly grab Azir, because he doesn't do bad into Zillion. So I just decided, alright, let's do it. And then I picked up Ashe, because Tornado's been doing really good on Ashe so far. Then they picked Ezreal, it does fine into Ashe, doesn't really matter. And banned Kane Illaoi, we banned Graves J4, and picked Gangplank, as they picked Malphite. And I picked Nunu, they picked Hecarim, which is interesting because Nunu counters Hecarim. But let's see, can we get a win on... Can we get another win? Please, I want one more. It could feel so good. No, we lose. Vixie went 2-8. But hey, he got half the team's kills. Well, I got one more game, right? Yeah, I want to draft against Crimson Moon. I don't know, are we focusing top lane any? We're kind of ignoring top lane. Let's just, bring up the focus in bot, take down the focus, in top and take down the focus in mid. I just kind of switch it over there. Let's see if that works for this next game. What the? Okay. What in the heck? Okay. Anyway, I'll be back in a sec. So, yeah, we got counterpicked a little bit. Draven and Anivia, Azir was the ban for me. Then they banned out Gnar, Renekton, Karma. Seeing the opportunity, I picked Lucian. They picked Kai'Sa, which does counter Lucian, and Fiddlesticks, and he's their support. I locked in Graves in the jungle, and then I locked in Senna, because Senna... Yeah, because Senna counters Kai'Sa, excuse me. I was reading my draft, I was like, did I misdraft you? No. And they picked Ekko. You banned Gragas Hecarim, they banned Rengar Kamil, and picked Nidalee. I picked Veigar, because Veigar counters... we needed AP. Because basically, after I drafted Lucian, and then I saw Kai'Sa Fiddle, I was like, well, Graves counters Fiddlesticks, and Senna counters Kai'Sa. So, I think I'm gonna go Senna Graves. And yeah, I was like, we have a bunch of AP. I need some AP, honestly. So yeah, we picked up Veigar Aatrox, and they picked Nasus, which also counters Aatrox. Nidalee counters Graves. So yeah, we got counterpicked a little bit in this draft, but I wasn't expecting to win anyway, right? Yeah. They lose to Crimson Moon, and Jirian does good on Graves, Vixie does not on Aatrox. 0-4. Other than Kai'Sa, gets the better of Tornado Senna, and Clifford can have to go. With that, we're going to swap back in Sours and sim these next three games. To the last four of the season, so let's go ahead and do that. Send these next three games. I think we had a bye week. We lose to Aetherwool, so that we do get five towers. Sours in his return, 2-3-1 on Shen. Corvin's Cho'Gath was the biggest issue. And Jirian actually went 4-2-4 on Kane. Tornado didn't do terrible on Jinx, but he didn't do super good either. Alright. Next game. We lose the Crystal, but also get 4 towers in that game. Kirchhoff went off on Katarina at 6-2-2. Tornado could not get the win with Senna. We had Misfortune support against the Veigar and Kalista, which is a very interesting bot. Maybe she bonded with Rengar. But yeah, we're popping off a little bit, like we're getting better, no doubt. Last game of this episode is a loss to Quantum, in which Kirchhoff and Tornado on Zigzagreal tried and failed to get broken. But yeah, I mean, Sours did that. But yeah, these last three games, we've actually been like getting kills and fouls. Like, we've actually been competing, like, slightly. We've been slightly competing, you know. I'm actually very happy with how we've ended this episode. Although the top lane is still a mystery. I have no idea who to start between Bixie and Sours. I guess for the next four games we'll start Bixie and make it even. But yeah, here are the standings right now. Crystal and Paladin tied at the top 14-4. 207 Shock and Quantum at 12-6. For 3rd and 4th, Crimson Moon and Excalibur, 5 and 6 at 10 and 8, Jade Crown, 9 and 9, Primal, 8 and 10, Imperium Masons and Silver Dragon, 7 and 11, Aether Wolves at 4 and 14, and obviously SI Gaming, 1 and 17. Here's your league leaders, Stakeer, lead the league in kills, Ghoulsack overtakes Rusty for the KDA lead, Lacoste still leads at, or in the assists, and Southern leads in CS. But I'd like to thank you all for watching. My name is Alvin Great. See you all next time.